One of the major benefits of SolidCAM is the associativity to the SolidWorks model. This can be great when something on your design changes. First, let's create some toolpaths on the initial part. As you can see, the machine is selected and the coordinate system, stock and target are defined. Drag and drop templates can be useful when you want to apply cutter paths to a component quickly. It really is as simple as dragging a template onto the SolidWorks model face you wish to machine. For the next operation, we don't have a template saved, so we'll simply create one from scratch. In this case, a 2D iMachining operation. iMachining is a great module everyone should consider purchasing to enhance their programming capabilities and increase productivity. It produces a morphing spiral toolpath that maintains a constant chip thickness throughout the duration. This gives the user the possibility of full flute machining to speed up the machining process. In specific materials, iMachining can reduce your roughing operations by over 70% against conventional machining strategies. First, we will create an iRough and finish operation. Within the feature recognition mode, we will use the outside feature option. This machines from the initial stock down to the outside profile of a component, saving the time of having to select any geometry. As you can see, a blue preview is shown of the area that will be machined on the SolidWorks model. After applying the initial toolpath, we can then save and copy the toolpath to then create a further iMachining operation. This time, the recognition by faces will be used to machine the main open pocket. After this has been calculated, an alternative to saving copy in a toolpath is to drag a toolpath in the SolidCAM tree to another face on the model. By holding the control key down, gives you the possibility to select multiple faces. Alternatively, simple Windows commands can be used to copy and paste operations. Once this is done, we will change the feature recognition mode to recognition by chains. This needs to be used when machining pockets that go all the way through the job, as there is no bottom face to select. These techniques can be great to reuse operations to machine other areas of the job using the same technical data. Let's now just add a simple drilling operation to drill the 4mm holes. Now we're at a stage where we can post-process. However, before we do this, let's replicate a design change. Going back to the SolidWorks feature tree, we could change dimensions within a sketch or feature. However, turning on Instant 3D makes this process even quicker. By simply selecting the face of a feature, brings up all the dimensions within that feature, and can easily be modified. Now the model has been modified, you will notice all the toolpaths look as though they're out of synchronisation. By clicking anywhere in the SolidCAM Manager, it automatically synchronises and recalculates to the newly updated model. This functionality also works with 3D toolpaths, as well as more complex 4-5 axis toolpaths, and even turning and mill turn operations. Before the model is changed, let's drag a process template onto this complex 3D model. A process template is similar to a template and works in the same manner. The only difference is that a process template contains a group of toolpaths. This can be great if you always follow the same procedures to rough out similar components. All we need now to do is to wait for all the calculations to complete. Once complete, a great tool within SolidCAM is the updated stock. Enabling this, we can show the resultant stock after a given toolpath by dragging the stock box to the required operation. This gives the programmer the assurance that everything is good at each machining operation without having to simulate toolpaths. Again, let's make a change to the part being machined. This could be a direct change on the mould, or even back at the early stages of designing the moulded component. In this instance, I'm going to roll back the feature tree to when the initial part was designed. For simplicity, the delete face command is going to be suppressed, resulting in a large hole being added into the component. Rolling the feature tree back to the end shows the resultant change in the mould. Now the change has been made, again let's go back to the SolidCAM manager. Similar to previous, all the toolpaths automatically resynchronise and calculate to the modified component. As you can see from reviewing all the toolpaths and a check of the updated stock, the large circular boss has now been machined into the component. These methods really do speed up the process if a design change occurs within the SolidWorks model.